Express yourself. Black Violin's Masterclass series here on YouTube. We also have a Easter Sunday show, 6 p.m. We're doing a live stream. It is on stageit.com/Black Violin. What can the people expect, Will?
You can expect an incredible show. right? I mean, we don't have Nat Stokes and DJ SBS.
Shout out to Nat Stokes.
That's sad. You know, I'm weeping right now because we can't have him. But it's still going to be an incredible show, an impactful show. It's all about hope, right? The songs of hope. It's about inspiring and uplifting everybody during these tough times, these rough times. That's what it's all about. And, yeah, man, just tune in. 6 p.m. Easter Sunday, Songs of Hope. Don't forget, you got to set a reminder on your phone. I know nobody got nothing to do. You at home with your kids. It's all good. Just vibe with us on Easter Sunday. Yeah.
Yep. Make sure you go check us out. It's stageit.com/blackviolin. It's a pay what you can type of situation. So, you know, if you do what you can to help out, it's really about songs of hope. You know, it's going to be really about just playing things to make everybody feel better. You know, if you ever been to a Black Violin show, it's going to be very similar to that vibe. We live in Florida, so we're going to do it outside. So, you know, we're going to bring the outside indoors. So that'd be good if it's not too hot, because it is steaming outside. But it should be dope. Oh, it should be a good vibe. Make sure that you check us out on all the socials, Facebook.com, Instagram, Twitter is all at Black Violin. And if you're watching us right now live on YouTube, then make sure you tell a friend and press subscribe. All right.
And a thumbs up. If you like it. If you don't like it, it's all good.
Yeah, people go at people. Like, I noticed on the last master's class, there was a thumbs down, and they were mad. People were like, what you mean you got a dislike on that?
It's always going to be one of those. It's
I
all
like
good.
That, though. You know what I mean? It's like, all you good. Know, it, if they ain't hating, then you ain't doing something right. So, so today's master class, the purpose of this master class today is about focusing on unlocking your creative side to help you make, you know, your own original music that you like. I think a lot of it, a lot of kind of why people are normally like, how do you guys do what you do, is because we just make up our own music. And that's, you know, it's kind of a theme of ours. We always preach that's the reason why we still playing this, is because this is not our parents' instrument or our teacher's instrument. We just kind of figured our way. And for us, we're just sort of, you know, along the way, just, you know, it's hard for us to explain how it happened for us, but we're going to try to, in this masterclass, explain to you how to just create music that, you know, feels good to you. We hope to broaden your understanding of music composition a little bit, you know, and also introduce you to how popular music is created, right? So let's start it off with just the idea of, like, everybody inside them has sort of, like, this melody, right? You know, I think so.
That's true. I mean, everybody has a... Yo. So we had a little technical difficulty. Something happened. Corona, probably. You know what I'm saying? Right. But I'll let Kev get back in, and we'll continue the masterclass. I think ultimately our goal is to try to get you to bring out the artist in you. You know, I think as musicians, we consider ourselves as almost like, you play this piece of music, particularly string musicians. You play this music, you played it on a sheet of paper, and that's it. You know, I think there's an artist in all of us, man. And I think our goal right now is to get you to get us to pull that out of you, you know?
Yeah, man. And also just about the idea of what's that melody that's inside you, you know? Like, everybody has just sort of like this vibe that's inside them. I remember when I was creating my first beat ever. I was in college at the library in the FIU. Shout out to FIU. And I was at the library working at an information desk, and there was this music lab on the fifth floor. And it was the first time I ever like got introduced to making music. And I found that beat the other day. And it's funny because it's the first beat I ever made ever. And the chords are the same chords as Rise, that is the first song of our album, of the new album. And it's like, because those chords, like I always said, it's like those chords are just in me. It's like, that's just, I don't know, if there's a progression or a melody that, you know, I wake up with, that's me. And I think that everybody has that with inside of them, you know, just sort of like whatever their vibe is, whatever their influences are. It's like a musical personality, so to speak.
Yep,
you know,
absolutely.
What I mean? So I think that everybody has it. So it's like, you know, we want to kind of just, you know, maybe kind of figure that out. So, you know, what's yours? You know, give the people an idea of sort of like, what's your melody or something simple, something we could loop, But right. like, what's that like thing that's you?
Let's see.
Dope. So that's just like kind of like what's inside you, right? Like that's just sort of, you know, definitely in this moment, but whatever that vibe is. We want you guys to think about the same thing at home. You know, just kind of come up with your own melodies, you know. Spend some time with your instrument without music and come up with whatever vibes and whatever feels good on that, you know. So what do you feel on that, Will? Throw some layers in there. Talk a little bit more about this in our sound effects class in a couple of weeks. That's like, you know, just, you know, what your vibe is at this moment, right?
Yeah. And literally, I'm just making that up right now. And I was adding a lot of different elements to it. I started off with the simple, you know, bass. And then I added some bass to it, you know. Typically, at this moment, I probably add some drums to it. But there's a lot of rhythmic stuff happening already. So it's not necessary at this moment. But you just go with wherever it goes, you know. Wherever you go, it goes, you know. And I don't think I'm just being who I am. I'm expressing myself the way that I want to express myself creatively. And that's it. And you just go wherever it goes and it'll go.
So then that's like sort of the basis of a song then, right?
I mean, yeah. Right now there's I was still building it, but if I take out certain things, like if you're trying to, let's say you're trying to write a verse or something like that, then you take out certain elements just to kind of like allow the vocals or whatever. You can actually play a solo to it, allow that to breathe, and then you can add more elements to it if there's a hook that you develop to add more to make it that much more impactful. So it's, again, this is just like literally 5 minutes messing around. So this can go so many different places.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, like, you know, we're talking about, you know, hooks and verses. We'll get into that even a little bit more later about the format of a song. But, you know, if that's the basis of a song, then really, like, the question is, well, what makes a good song, right? I mean, that's sort of the million-dollar question. Like, how do you write, like, you know, a good song that just comes from you? It's what you feel. It's real. But, you know, what even makes a good song, or what makes a complete song in general, you know? And, you know, so it makes me think of, like, how I think of a good song. And any song that I ever remember, I think of a song that creates an emotional response, you know, so to speak. Like, you know, a song that just, like, either makes me smile or that's my jam, it makes me lit, or it just, like, you know, makes me feel like love. It makes me feel, like, makes me think. You know, that's to me what a good song, that's sort of the basis of a good song, is just, you know, that, like, some sort of emotional response when it comes on, you know, what's that feeling, you know, how to describe it. And that's what good music and good art is to me, is just this emotional response that artists understand and know how to tap into people, you know?
Right, regardless. I mean, if the response is like, ew, you know, it,
I mean, but not
that's
for nothing.
An emotional response.
Not for nothing. Like, think about, like, metal, right? Like, you know, heavy metal music. And, you know, yes, perhaps it's not the most soothing, you know, it's not, you know, maybe the songs you're going to make love to or anything, but it's more about the idea of, you know, it's just that energy, you know, it does give you an emotional response, you know, when you hear that. So I'm just really interested in all art that does that, you know, visual, audible art, any art that really makes you think and just go on a different place, you know. That's really what I'm about. So, you know, we challenge you guys, like, you know, we ask you guys, like, what's your favorite song? And, you know, we want you to throw it in the comments. What's your favorite song and why? Like, what's the emotional response that comes with it? It could be any song. It could be some, you know, Drake songs, anything, you know, that just came out.
Katy Perry song. She's like my favorite.
You love Katy Perry?
Yeah, I love some Katy Perry.
That's a guilty pleasure. No. So, you know, so what's your favorite songs then? Like, give me a favorite song of yours. Maybe something that, you know, everybody at home could understand. Maybe something, you know, a little current.
One of my favorite songs right now that I'm listening to is, there's an artist by the name of Chronix. He's a reggae artist, does a lot of reggae stuff. And one of my favorite songs is Black is Beautiful. And it just basically talks about his interpretation of what he thinks that black is, and his idea of how beautiful it is. And he expresses it in such a unique, beautiful way. It's poetry, honestly. And for me, the music, the kind of music that I like, literally paints a picture in my head. When I hear something that literally I can see a movie in my head, I'm just immediately drawn to that. And that song is it's one of my favorite songs right now that I listen to all the time. And it definitely provokes an emotional response from me, because I'm thinking about just my kids and how I love them, my wife and my sisters and my family, you know, just how much I care about everybody. So it definitely makes me feel love, makes me feel good.
Yeah, that's a great one. Right now I'm listening to Snow Allegra, a lot of Snow Allegra, love her. And I don't know, it's just, you know, think about the song Whoa she has. It's, you know, I don't know, it's just such a great just love song. It makes me feel really good. It's like warm and cozy is kind of how I catch, that's the emotional response I get from really all her music, all her new album. But that's why it's on repeat for me, because maybe at this moment that's what I need, you know. And as a musician, as an artist, you know, both of our examples, you know, I don't know if they were going for it, but they probably were. You know, do you think that that's the response that Chronix was going for on that?
Like, absolutely, I think so. I think, and obviously, you interpreted music however you interpret it, but I would like to believe the reason and the response that I got is if I actually spoke to him and told him this is the response that I got, he'd be like, yeah, that's good. That's what it was intended.
Yeah.
And I think ultimately when an artist is creating music, right, and if it's a music about love and it makes you think about love and think about your loved ones, then yes, I think that artist would be like, oh, that was my intentions. And like you mentioned the heavy metal, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. If you listen to heavy metal, it makes you want to, you know, hit a wall. Then yeah.
Or maybe like, you know, but heavy metal makes me really want to go hard in my workouts.
Right.
It's an intensity of it, you know, like that I love. I mean, and I think all of these things, all of these emotional responses has a place, you know. It's all about what you're into, what your influences are, the kind of art that you respond to, and also just sort of what you're doing at this moment. There's certain songs that I listen to in a workout, you know, but I would never listen to just like sitting down on my couch, you know?
Right.
And then vice versa, like the songs that I listen to when I read, that just this calming kind of, you know, just really awesome, like a lot of classical music or lush kind of romantic music. But if I did that during a workout, I'd fall asleep, you know? So, you know, I think it's like different songs have different meanings and have different times where you could use them, you know?
And I don't think there's a right answer. I mean, I think it's all depends on the person and your personality and the things that move you, you know what I mean? I personally like things that are a bit more storytelling driven, you know, and things that I listen to words, I listen to every content of a song. So for me, that's what drives me, you know what I mean? So it all depends on you. There's no right answer. I can listen to something and I'm just like, yo, this is dope, this is crazy, it makes me feel this. And you listen to it and you're like, yeah, that won't make me feel nothing, you know?
So, yeah, that's
so it
true.
It all depends on the person, you know?
But there's no right answer. That is art. And it's like, that's why we go back to this idea of how do you create and write your own songs, you know? Like, that's what this whole thing is just because you can write things that go different places. You can write things for different reasons, right. You know, and, you know, so it's just like, what is the purpose of it? And I think that's sort of what you got to kind of figure out first, you know, if you got a purpose for what you're trying to do.
Right,
here,
right.
So. Anybody give us a song?
Oh.
See, even Lean On Me, you know, right? When I think of Lean On Me, that song particularly, I think of just hope. I think of inspiration. But, you know, yeah, I don't know. It just has this, like, we can do anything. I feel like a marching kind of, like a protest vibe to it a little bit. Like, anything is possible kind of vibe to it. And
definitely.
You know, I think, like you were saying before, lyrics have a lot to do with it, too. You know, this bass line, it feels like that, but then when you hear lean, I can't say it, boy. I was about to do it, but when you say lean on me, when we're not strong, I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on. Like,
right.
Oh, like, you know what I mean? Like, that is so strong.
Lean on me, lean on the strong, I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on. It won't be long, 'cause I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Yeah. Rest in peace to the great Bill Withers. If you don't know, Google him. He has an amazing catalog. So, yeah. But, I mean, even in that song, like, you know, that just the characteristics of it, it's just hope. It's just amazing energy. Positivity is what I take from it, you know.
So fitting for this time right now.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, anybody else have any favorite songs on there? Oh, Impossible. Well, you know, yeah. That song, like, Impossible is Possible, our song is, you know, we wrote it on, you know, definitely about hope, you know, definitely about similar vibe to the Bill Withers stuff. And that's hopefully what you took from that random song.
Right.
Sanctuary, Joji. Joji. Oh yeah. No, I know Joji. I don't know that song. What's does do they say what they feel from it? Interesting.
Yes, it does.
Donnie Hathaway.
That's
say that.
That's another song. Yeah, Donnie Hathaway.
Yeah, Donnie Hathaway. What's the song again?
Someday we'll all be free.
Oh man, you know.
You know what? I love the live version of that better than the actual recording. But yeah, that's another great song. Again, it's songs that provoke that emotional response, like Kev said. That song just makes you, man, especially now as you're watching us and we're doing this, you know what I'm saying? Hopefully everyone is safe and I don't know what you guys are individually going through. Everyone's going through things and, you know, songs that can talk about the current times and make you just feel like, you know, there's a light at the end of the tunnel. You know what I mean? Like, we all need that at times, you know, and that song definitely does that. It just makes you, sometimes you feel hopeless. Sometimes you wake up in the morning, just feel hopeless. You feel like, what am I here for? What am I going to do today? You know? And that's what music does, man. You turn on the music and it just makes you take that extra step. You know, it makes you move forward, because sometimes it's hard to move forward. So yeah, that's why music is so beautiful, man. That's why we do what we do. And yeah, man.
And it's so important too, you know. I mean, you know, especially in times like this, you know. So it's great to be a musician right now, be able to do this. And that's why we want to, you know, teach you guys and show you guys this workshop is a bit more about just sort of talking through some of the things, you know. You know, melodies can be so simple, and they can kind of, you can create emotional responses just musically in just so many different ways. So, like, for instance, like, you could do things with, you know, if you're a violinist or any instrument you play, but just in volume, you know, that can make things have more intensity. It can make things calmer. You know, you can create things in your music just with simple things. So, like, something like even... even something like that, you know? I mean, it's like, it starts off, you know, this is nice and calm. And then you add vibrato. And there's more intensity, you know? Right. So there's so many different things that you can do that I think just in your playing. How about, so that's like soft to loud. You can do something like even major to minor if you play a major scale. That's happy, you know. Right. That makes me feel good. That's like, you know, it's going to be positivity. Right. It's going to be feelings of, you know, rainbows.
Sunshine and rainbows, yeah.
But then same scale, but minor.
Some clouds. A little bit of clouds. It's raining a little bit.
It's a little rainy, you know. It's a little, you know, tough outside. So it's like, you know, I think those kind of things are musical techniques, a musical theory that you learn that you're able to actually implement. And put that in your music and create emotional responses just based on if you make it major or minor.
Right.
In general, just always, since we're talking about major and minor, most songs that you like are in minor, just so you know. So minor just has, you know, it's just more dimension. So a lot of things that you hear, a lot of popular music's in minor. Major, you know, it's Happy Birthday, and, you know, Pharrell, Happy is in major. There's a few songs, yeah, but most really, like, big songs are in minor. So don't be afraid of minor. And minor doesn't have to be sad. It can, you know, it's all about how you use it. You
right.
know?
It can be epic. It can be impactful.
It can definitely be epic. So, you know, those are just some of the different techniques. You know, we want you guys, you know, when you, sometime this week, take 10, 15 minutes out. Don't pull out your music. Maybe just practice scales and arpeggios. And afterwards, we want you to just kind of come up with your own melody, you know? Like, mine is, let's see, like...
Thank you guys so much for tuning in, Masterclass. Again, like Kev mentioned, when you're at home, just pick up an instrument, try to create your own melody, try to find your own voice, and then, and also too, just pick out a song, one of your favorite songs, and just talk about to yourself or to someone else why that song really make you feel the way that it makes you feel. And I think it's important as artists, as musicians, to connect with our music and connect with our instruments. So try that at home, just create your own melody. Once again, we are Black Violin, Will Baptiste, Kev Marcus, and we are signing out.
And if anyone has any questions. Awesome, Chelsea. What's up? Hey, Chelsea and the 15 students watching. We love you guys.
My cellist wondering
if you ever play with a cellist or bassist. Do
we ever play with a cellist or bassist? Absolutely. Shouts out to Joe Cello.
Joe Cello. Shouts out to that cello guy. Now, we got a bunch of people we play
Super
with.
Super Dave, rest in peace.
Yeah, Super Dave, man. You know, so we've played with a lot of cellists and bass players over the years. We play with a lot of them on stage, too, just, you know, as performers. You know, we bring kids on stage all the time. Youth orchestra, so yeah, we do it all the time. But you know, I think it's because Wills have played viola that's really helpful and just the vibe of it. If we were just both violinists, then we'd have to do something. But you know,
right.
Shout out to Don Hicks. I was gonna put that in there. Don't worry, it was coming. Don Hicks has been doing all of the resources for us. So you know, if you go to blackviolin.net/masterclass, you can see some resource material. He'll give you like you know some stuff as far as the scales we use today and things that you. For teachers, you could use to use as a resource for your students. So Don Hicks, Bethune Elementary, if you
Bethune in the building,
love you guys. It's our school. Love you guys. So thank you guys. Oh yeah, this the website. Well, I wouldn't say it's free. I didn't say it was free.
What website is free?
No, there's no website free. It's the one I use. There's plenty of them, but you know, like even that beat that you know we pulled out right before that we started this freestyle with, I just went on it. It's called splice.com. It's like $10. You know, we are not an ad, and it's not an ad for them.
We're not sponsored at all.
Not sponsored at all.
Should be, but
you know. But if you listen to Splice, what up? But yeah, nah, it's dope. And like even like really literally like 5 minutes before the podcast, I just went and it was like, hey, well, what you think of this beat, and then we just rock to it, and it's just a vibe. So, yeah, check it out, splice.com. Mayana says, should students build up a library of grooves?
Yeah, I guess.
I mean, don't you think we kind of have a library of grooves? Like, we can just kind of at any moment just play a vibe and a groove that feels like us?
Right.
So I don't think about it like necessarily recording it or anything. It's just almost like...
Right.
And like any moment, I could just.
Right.
You know, I just,
well, I think for us, it's internal, right? We have this, I guess, the library. I'm thinking about literally like sitting down, creating something, and stashing it somewhere in the hard drive. I think we have a lot of grooves internally that, like for me particularly, if I pick up my viola and I start plucking it, I start playing, and I go to these grooves that I have mentally that I always go to. Yeah, so I think it's healthy to practice and find your own melody and grooves and I think it is helpful, you know what I mean? So I think yeah. get your library of grooves.
Get your grooves together. I like that. The groove library. No. Yeah. I think it's important. I think we did it without thinking about it. So yes, I think, you know. Come up with those grooves. Yeah. It's a great question. Yeah. Oh yeah, guys. Come on. Thank you, producer. I want to give a special shout out to Lex and Jenny. GTPS, they always come through. They got their mask on. They got the Purell on deck.
Lex Luger.
You know, got the edits going. You see them crawling under the camera, you know. So much appreciated to them. Got that Purell on deck. We do have an Easter show this Sunday, 6 p.m. It is Songs of Hope. We're doing it in our garden. It's an outdoor concert. So, you know, if you guys aren't doing too much, you don't think many people are, make sure you tune in. It is stageit.com/blackviolin. Make sure you follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/blackviolinmusic. Instagram @blackviolin. Twitter @blackviolin. YouTube, make sure you tell a friend and press subscribe. Thank you, guys. This one is A flat. I'm
Thank you.